Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. So far, we have been creating variables, which generally store single objects or single values. So take, for example, an integer. That's typically just one number. So we assign that number to a variable. More often or not, there is a need for us to store multiple values referenced by one variable. So let's take a look at the list data type. The list data type is one of four built-in data types in Python used to store collections of data. Of the four different data types in Python used to store collections, they all have their different characteristics. It's just that the list is probably one of the most versatile data types available in Python. You will probably find them in virtually every Python program. So just to summarize the list data type, the list data type is a collection of values or objects. It allows us to store multiple values or objects in a single variable. This is an example of a list. Notice that the lists are created using square brackets. One way to recognize what data type we're using, out of the four built-in data types used to store collections, the three more popular here, tuples, lists, and dictionaries, we can see that the tuple will be utilizing the parentheses, the list uses the square brackets, and a dictionary will be utilizing the curly braces. So to build a list, we utilize these square brackets. You can see that the items in the list are all separated by a comma. We can utilize multiple data types within our list. And you can see, for example, following the rules we've learned previously, here we have a string, so it's limited by the single quotes or the doubles. You can see that we have a boolean, we have a floating point or float, and then we have an integer, for example. So let's go for a quick example. So we create a new variable. We use these square brackets to define the fact we're building a list, and then we can add some values. So we can go ahead and print, and we can check the type. So let's check the type. Just run this. You can see that we're now utilizing a list data type. So I can go ahead and print this list. So let's just go ahead and also now print the list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So like I mentioned, we can pretty much store any object here. So whether it be a Boolean, for example, or whether it be a string. So this is just some of the data types that we've been utilizing so far, and floats. There is no real limit in regards to what objects we can store within the list. As I alluded to at the start, each of the four data types built into Python used to store collections of data, they all have different characteristics. So these are the main characteristics of a list. So the list is ordered. Having an ordered list makes it really quite useful to work with the data in our application. So when I say ordered, what we mean here is that the order that we specify the data will be the order in which the data is returned. And that's the important thing here. So imagine we wanted to, for example, grab some data from the database and we wanted to display that data to the user. So typically we might grab the data from the database. We might then format that data into a list. And then we can utilize that list type then to iterate over, to print out to the user. Now, when we print out that data, we may want to put it into some sort of order. So we can order our list or the data in our list, for example, and then output that data to the user. But the point here is that the list is ordered. So the list order you can see here will always be the list order. It won't ever change. As we've already explained, the list can store any arbitrary objects. That makes the list really flexible to work with, the fact that we can store multiple types of data in one place. Because we are working with multiple values in one variable, there still might be a need for us to extract a single value from that list. Now, in order to do that, we're going to need some sort of system to be able to select certain values in that list. And this is how we can access those single values, by utilizing an index. We will learn more about the index in an up-and-coming tutorial. Probably one of the most common reasons why the list is very popular is because the list is very dynamic. And by that, I mean that we can add new data to the list. We can remove specific items from the list. We can add new items to the list in specific places by utilizing the index. Ultimately, the index is very dynamic in how we can work with the list. So something you might be new to and is very commonly referred to when discussing data types and other elements in programming is this idea of immutable and mutable objects. Now, so far, we've been discussing different data types such as strings, integers, or floats, and these type of objects are considered immutable. And that means that once we've assigned these values, they cannot be changed. I've already mentioned that the list is very dynamic. We can change and add to the list, and therefore the list is considered mutable. Once we've created a list, added some different elements, objects, we can go ahead then and add and remove and delete the elements within our list. Thus, why we consider a list as a mutable data type. So now we have learned some of the underpinning knowledge of the Python list. Let's now spend more time practicing and utilizing some of the tools that are available to create and work with lists in Python.